This tutorial is going to show you how to make a track mat in Adobe Premiere. This is kind of a clumsy way to do it in comparison to what you would do in, let's say, After Effects, but it is a useful technique. So what I've done here is I've imported a video and I've cropped it a bit. It's far darker than I would probably want in most cases for this this kind of application, but it'll serve our purposes. You can see it's shaky footage, it's not very good footage. That actually kind of works for this project. So I've also created a title, this is in Thornton Park in Orlando, and I've made a font that's thick enough, and I've adjusted its size so it looks pretty good. I might actually make it a little bit tighter and increase my size a little bit. Just to be able to, so I'm sure I'm going to be able to see everything the way I want. So, this looks pretty good. So, what I'm going to do from here is to drag that title on top. And you can see that, it doesn't really, that's not going to work. You know, I mean, that's just clumsy. And of course, it still shows me the footage, and that's not what I want. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to make the footage only appear in the text. And the cool thing about this is that this could work with any solid image, because basically what it's doing is it's keying out the white, and you'll see that in a second. But that means that any Photoshop image that is a solid color or any set of solid colors could be done in the same way. So what I'm going to do is apply a video effect called the track mat key. I would just type in track in effects, but it's in keying. And I'm going to drag that onto my video. And it doesn't look like it's done anything, but what you can see is that it's actually going to give me a mat here. And I can choose to, in this case, use Video 2, which is my title. You can also, if this is titled something different, like let's say it's titled Mask, then you can actually select it there. Video 2, and you can choose Alpha or Luma. In this case, Alpha is the one that you can that you want. If you are then changing the size of your title or adjusting anything with that, that is also animated. So let's say I wanted to move, so right now it looks like this, which is pretty cool. But let's say I want to animate it out so I can actually have it move around or increase the scale, etc. And it will still be within that same process. So let's say I want it to be, to start off really small here. Let's say at, let's say at 0, and then I'm going to move to 100, around in the midpoint, and I'm going to move to, even bigger, here, so it looks like it's actually zooming in completely. And that's going to give me 3 keyframes, so what it's going to do is actually track it along with that. And you can see that it starts off small, it grows big about halfway through, and then it keeps continuing to grow, so it looks as if the entire thing is coming towards you. And of course, depending on what this was, if this was nature footage or something like that, or if the font was really thick or if it was a shape, you would actually be able to see more of the content. But you can see if this was done quickly, how effective it could be. So let's say I just want to delete out this middle keyframe and have this one occur far faster. Then I could actually get a much quicker feel to this. Now, like I said, it's a little clumsy for what you might want, but it's also pretty interesting. You can do some pretty amazing things with just a very, very simple effect. Enjoy.